So in today's class, we are going to learn Informatica Data Director. This is also called IDD. So basically, what is this? What is IDD? Let's try to understand. So we have seen many web applications, right? Like if you will talk simple about Facebook, let's take a Facebook is a web application, right? Like we can play with the Facebook app just accessing its like facebook.com, then we will be able to see the front end and we will be able to do some actions, and that actions get applied internally in the back end of database, right? So same like that, we can create some web applications, and it will give us a flexibility, and which will give us a URL after creating the IDD applications, which will give us specific URL. And with the help of that URL, anyone can access that UI or front end of the IDD application. So we can make this URL secure after creating the different users and after providing the appropriate roles. Okay. So some same like hierarchy manager, we had seen. Like if there are some non-technical persons and they want to see the hierarchies of a person on different levels, so just they can search with the names, right? Or they can also create the different hierarchies. They can also edit that with the help of hierarchy manager. But that hierarchy manager we will able to access with the help of Informatica MDM console. Here we have seen. Let's connect to hierarchy one. So this was one hierarchy, right? So this was also one part of front-end applications. But the one limitation is that this hierarchy manager can only be accessed through what you say, this Informatica MDM console, right? So if you want to access this hierarchy manager, then we need to come to this Informatica MDM console. Then only we can access. But suppose due to some security problem, developer teams or administration team don't want to give this URL or this Informatica MDM console access to the other people. They are not means interested to give the access to the business who are not having the technical knowledge, right? So for them, what we can do, we can create our IDD applications and we can give the URL to the business guys. And they can play with all the base object tables from that application. They can create a record from IDD. They can edit the record. They can do the merging. Okay. So many steps they can do from the front end itself, such like a web application. Okay. So earlier, this IDD was called as a BDD. So then, so as you know that Informatica MDM was earlier known as Cyperion, right? Earlier known as Cyperion. So Cyperion had given a name of BDD. It is also called Business Data Director. So earlier, it was called as a Business Data Director. So this IDD was earlier called as a BDD, Business Data Director. Okay. Once this Cyperion was acquired by Informatica, then as we know that they changed the name of Cyperion from Cyperion to Informatica MDM, right? After acquisition of Cyperion by Informatica, they given a name, they changed the name of BDD to IDD. IDD. IDD means, now they change the name as a IDD. IDD means Informatica Data Director. So they changed the name of as a ITD. So earlier that was called as a BTD. Once that was clubbed with Cyprian, so that was called as a BTD. But now this is called as a IDD, Informatica Data Director. Okay, so with the help of this, we will be able to create a web type applications, and with the help of that web applications, user will be able to do all the interactions with the base object tables. So they have no need to come to database, or they have no need to come to this Informatica MDM. They can just put the URL in their web browser, and they can access that web application. They can access all the steps with the help of web applications.
Sujit, one question.
Yeah.
So this BDD is something related to BDE? That is different.
No, that is different one. BDE is a big data addition, right? So that is a different one. So BDE is
business data.
BDE, that is called big data addition. Okay. So once Power Center was clubbed with big data, okay. Once Informatica Power Center was made advanced feature of connecting with Hadoop ecosystem or big data, okay. Then that addition was called as a BDE, big data addition. And this BDE is a different thing.
So okay, that, I heard something like B2B or BTE something. Okay.
No, so that BDE is a different one. That is big data addition.
Oh.
And this BDE is okay. And this BDD is a different one. This is a kind of a simple web applications, and this is related with Informatica MDM. Now let's try to understand. There are some terms which are very important in IDD. Let's try to understand these terms. So you will see some terms like subject area group, subject area child, and subject area grandchild. So this term you will hear very frequently in IDD. So let's try to understand what are these terms. So subject area group and subject area. So we know that subject area group is a collection of different subject area, right? So what is subject area? So subject area, suppose you have many base subject tables in your Informatica MDM database. So as you know that we could have a customer, we could have address, we could have a department, we could have a country, right? We could have a different base object tables. So if we are pointing to a specific base object table, like if you are discussing about a specific base object table, so that is pointing a specific set of data, right? That is pointing to a specific subject area. Like if I am talking about customer, so it will only give us a detail about the customer data, right? So we can say this will only give a high level view of customer subject area. So here the subject area is customer. If you are discussing about address data or address based object, so this will give us information about address, right? So we can say that address is also a different subject area. Likewise, we could have a country as a different subject area. We could have a department as a separate subject area, right? So if you're discussing a specific set of data, specific set of area, so that will be called as your subject area. So in our project or practicals, if you have created like a customer, address type, so these all are the different subject area, okay? And what will be the subject area child? So suppose customer is related with what we say address, means suppose we have address ID in customer, and for getting the full information of the address, we need to join with address ID, then we can get the more address information, right? So here in that case, customer will become address will become parent and customer will become child. because you are dependent on address, right? So if you are configuring like, let's try to understand one schema view. Let's try to see it. So in the schema viewer, just we have created two tables, right? Here we have customer and here we have address. And here we have one relationship table which is combining these both the tables. Okay. So here we can see means address is the child of customer. Okay. And address is also related with customer. So if you discuss address as a subject area, then for address also customer will become the child. So if you are taking customer as a subject area, then what will be the subject area child of the customer? Address will become the subject area child of the customer. And suppose address is related with some third table, then in that case that third table will become the grandchild for the customer. Right? So in IDD we have two levels of interactions, like we can define a child and we can define a grandchild. So up to two level we can relate the tables and we can view the data. If you have the third levels or fourth levels, we cannot create any child, means we cannot create any beyond the grandchild. We can create a subject area that will be kind of parent. We can create a child subject area and we can create a grandchild subject area. Up to this we can only create. After that, if we have some relationship, we cannot go. Okay. So for understanding, let's try to create one more table. Okay. So we understood, right? What is subject area? So it deals with a specific set of data, and here the collection of different subject area will be called as a subject area group. So if you're talking about, there are some naming conventions we do follow that are the standard naming conventions. So there is no kind of mandatory that we have to use this, but yes, as a best practice, we do use this naming convention for understanding the different objects inside this IDD. So if you are creating any subject area group, then try to give a name as a SAG. If you are creating any subject area, then try to give a name as a SA. And if you are creating any subject area child, then try to give a name as a SSC, subject area child. And if you are creating any subject area grandchild, then we will give a name as a SHEC, subject area child, grandchild, right? So we'll try to follow this naming convention as a best practice. And suppose we are creating a customer subject area group, then the name will be something like this, SAG customer, and the name of subject area of the customer will be SA customer. Same like that, we could have a different child of this customer, we could have some grandchild of this customer. So let's try to come to schema view. Here you can see, so here we have the child but we don't have the grandchild, right? So let's create one more table and let's try to create a grandchild so that we can easily understand. Okay, so we can create, let's come to a schema, or we know, let's try to do a more drill down in hierarchies. Okay, if you are coming to hierarchies, and from here if you want to create one more base subject, entity base subject table, then how you can do that? So we know that in the previous classes we had converted the many base object tables to entity base object table. What I am doing, I am directly creating the entity base object table from here. Means I am creating the entity base object table from a scratch, because I don't have any base object which are related with the kind of, suppose I am creating a third table as a communication type. Right, in address we do have a kind of different communication, right? We could have an email, we could have a phone, we could have a chatting, right? So there could be many communication type, right? So let's try to create a child of address and the name will be communication type. So let's try to create that entity based object from here itself. So we are creating a new entity base object, right? Then okay. Let's try to give the name as B underscore communication underscore type. Okay. And here one thing we have to always remember, since we are creating an entity base object, so here you have to select a base object class code. So BU class code will be added as an extra column to make this base object as a entity base object. We have seen this, right? So always remember to select this. Now press OK. So here you can see communication type entity base object has been created. But here you cannot see any columns, right? So for columns, we have to come to a schema. And here we can see communication type has been created, right? This table. Now we can see the columns. So column, you know that this base object class code will be added to make this base object as an entity base object, right? We had selected this, and we know that row ID object is the primary key of this table. This, since this is a base object table, so this will always be present, right? Now let's try to add some columns, like let's try to communication type. Communication type, then we could have a communication description. Let's take only two, right? Let's save it. So this will act as a kind of lookup table. So there we will have a communication type, and after doing the lookup on communication type, we can find the communication description, right? So now we have created this table. Now let's again come to hierarchies. Try to implement hierarchies and try to create a relationship based object. See, if you are coming to a schema viewer, so here you can see this table has been created, but there is no connection with this table to anyone, right? So let's try to relate this table with the base object address. So let's come to hierarchies and let's create a relationship base object, entity relationship base object, which will relate the two entity base object, right? So we need to here relate the communication type base object and address base object. So these two are the different entities, right? So we want to combine these two entities, so that's why we are going to create a new relationship base object. Yes, okay. So here many things will come. First of all, let's try to give the name of this. Let's give the name as B. Let's go to relationship table, and that will be communication type. Let's give a meaningful name. So here we have to select address, because we are relating address, and here we then you need to select the base object communication type, right? So first entity base object table is address, and second entity base object table is a communication type. And here let's select in hierarchy foreign key column, let's select a hierarchy code, and here let's select the relationship type code. Okay, so what this MDM will do, it will create this table, and it will, within this table, because this is a relationship table, so it will contain the row ID object of address, it will contain the row ID object of B communication type. So this is creating a mapping between these two tables, right? So with the help of this table, we can easily find out the means other information of communication type, right? And as you know that this hierarchy code and relationship code is being added due to the hierarchy, because this is the relationship hierarchy based object table. That's why these two extra column will be added. So now let's try to create it. So that table we can see here, right? B relationship communication type. So this has been created now. Now let's try to define an entity for this entity base object. We had done it, right, in the previous class. Let's try to repeat it. Add entity type. So let's give the entity type name as communication only. Communication, and let's select some colors of it. Let's select some address, some icons. Communication, let's select a let's select the envelope. We can take any icons. Let's save it. Now if you are coming to what we say, yeah, we have created the what we say entity type of this entity based object, right? We have created it. Now let's try to come to this relationship table. And now try to create the add relationship type. So if you are creating, if you are trying to give a name of this relationship type, so earlier we had given a name of like relationship type between address and customer, as customer has this address, right? And we want to give a name of relationship type in between address and communication type, right? So we can say that this particular address having, or this communication type having this address, like or this communication type belongs to, or this particular address belongs to this communication type, like communication type like email, phone, something like that, right? So we can give the name as belongs to also. So let's give the name of belongs to. We can give any meaningful name. Can give having also this address is having this communication type, right? So in place of belongs to, we can also take a having. Let's take having. It's a small. We are giving a name as having. Now let's select some color. So the first base object is address, second is a communication, and let's try to select the bilateral relationship and that will be available in a first hierarchy. Let's save it. So now this is available, right? So if you want to map now, if you come to a schema viewer, now let's try to refresh it. So now we can see, we are able to see the actual data model of the tables. So now this customer is related with this address with the help of this relationship table. And this address is related with this communication type with the help of this relationship table, right? So now we can see this customer is having a one child that name is address, and this customer is having a grandchild which name is communication type, right? So if you want to combine this profile, if you want to combine this hierarchy, what the hierarchy type you have created in a profile. Now let's come to admin. So we have created an admin profile, right? So here just click the second relationship type. So earlier we had only one relationship type. Now let's try to create this second relationship type. Now save it. Now if you will save it, here you will be able to see all the tables. We had created this table, so you will be able to see this table, and you will be able to see this table also, right? So now you can go for the, now you can go and create a two packages, put and display package for this, because here it will be required, right? And you can create a put and display package for this also, for this. And you can configure this tooltip and communication type, what the things we had done earlier, right? So you can get one more extra kind of. So let's try to do it. Let's try to recap the things that it will be better for us to understand this hierarchy also. So let's try to create the, what we say, Yeah, display and put package. For this, create a package for entity based object. This name, let's give the name as this is query, right? Query, this is for communication type, and that is display. Select the communication type. This is your package. This is your display package. Let's select only business columns. Display package has been created. Now let's create a put package. Table is communication type. Package name is put. That will be PKG. Now make this as a put. Next. And select all, let's select the business columns. So now we have created two packages for the custom communication type, right? Now let's come here and let's try to create a two package for this relationship type. So here you have to select create package for relationship object. Now let's give the name as keyword y, that is for relationship communication type. And this is your display package. Display query. Let's select this communication type. Now let's make it as a package. Let's make it a display package. And this is a relationship table. So let's only we'll have the relationship columns which are already selected here. You can see, right? Let's finish it. Now let's select a put package for relationship based object. This will be put. Select this communication type. Sorry. Here we are giving the magic query, right? Query, then here the package name. That's fine. Let's make it as a put. Next, let's only select the columns, required columns, finish it. So now we have created the respective packages for entity type and relationship type. Now let's come here and now you know that we can select this display package, we can select this put package, and let's try to select this columns. So here let's say communication type. In tooltip, let's say communication type and communication description. Here let's take a base object table, ID object only, and here let's take all the columns. Let's save it. Okay, we need to define this label pattern, right? So let's put this and let's put this comma. This, let's save it. You can give some meaningful name of this label and toolkit pattern also, like a previous example. Now let's come to this relationship type having, and here you can do the same thing. Select put and display package, and let's here take a relationship type code only. Here let's take a relationship type. So this is comma, right? So we'll take a row ID object and let's check all these columns. Sorry, we need to define tooltip pattern. Let's select this. Now select it. Double click it. Select it. Now save it. Now if you'll come to hierarchy manager, you'll see one more relationship has been created. So let's try to add some data for that from this backend. So we have not added any data for this communication type, right? So let's add some data. So let's take a state indicator active, base object class called communication. Let's give a ph, and the communication description is your phone, right? New record has been added. Now let's create one more communication type. Let's give it a email, and description is also email. One more record has been created. So we have created a two communication type, right? Now let's try to relate this communication type. Now let's try to create some mapping. Come here, have a state indicator one. Sorry, yeah, active hierarchy code. Let's take the hierarchy one. Relationship type code here we have to select the having, right? Because we are making a relationship between address and communication type. So address, let's take anyone first address, and let's point this address at this communication type. Let's add one more record.
Sujit.
Yeah.
Yeah. Here, how address row ID of address is coming automatically 2001. You just entered the rows, right? How 2001 came there?
No, 2001 is coming because in the previous class we had added some record to the base object. Here you can see. This is coming from here. For address, this is coming from here. For communication type, this will come from here. And for customer, this will come from here. So 2001, why this is coming for two? Okay, I'm connected with the wrong wires. Because 2001 is not here, right? Let's try to connect with hierarchy one. So here you can see yesterday we had created loaded the data from landing tables, right? So on that time, this row ID object was created automatically by MDM for these records. Same like that for customer also, that was created. And for relationship type, there was some row ID object created. So that was created automatically when you had loaded the data in the previous class from loading tables. Okay. So that row ID object we can see here. Let's make this address with already we define up. Let's take only three records in this table. Now let's try to come to hierarchy manager. And if you are searching for any entity, then here you can see three entities are available. You can search on the basis of communication type also. Okay. Earlier we had searched on the basis of address and customer. Now you can search the records on the basis of communication type. And if you have communication type also, like if you have a PH as a communication type and you want to see what are the different addresses which belongs from this PH communication type, then you can see it. And once you have address, then you can also see the respective customers which are related with that address. So let's see it. Let's take Hubspot state indicator one active. And here you can see all the communication types. So we have two communication types, right? We have just created PH and email. Now let's select this PH. So we can see this PH is available. Now let's fetch one hook. So we can see all the addresses which are related with this communication type. So that is a one relationship type, right? That is a one level of relationship type. So this is relating address and communication type, right? And suppose if you want to see which are the customers which are related with this address or from this address, just right click and click on fetch one hook. So here it is showing all the customers related with this address. Okay. So if you have a communication type also, here you can see the different addresses and then you can see the different customers. Right. Likewise, you can extend this hierarchy manager functionality on the different levels. Here we have a three levels, right? Communication type, address, and customer. So likewise, you can extend it to household, you can extend it to organization, right? And if you have any information, then you can drill it down from here itself. Okay, like if you want to drill down this customer, like how many addresses are there, you just fetch one more and it will show all the addresses of this customer. Fine. If you want to see how many other people are associated with this address, fetch one more. Then this is also pointing to the third person, right? So you can see how how easy this become, right, after doing the configuration. And then technical or business people can easily understand what the data they're having inside the database, right? So that just we have recapped this hierarchy feature. So we have just drilled down and we have made one more entity based object and we have related it. Now let's come back to a schema viewer and let's try to concentrate on IDT now. So for IDT we need a grandchild, so we have created the grandchild as a communication type, right? So now if you are coming to the Excel sheet, yeah, so in Excel sheet only three things we had, like we had a subject area, we had a subject area child, and we had a subject area grandchild. Okay, so you always have to keep in mind, like if you are creating a subject area for customer, so you can only drill down the customer tables. You cannot add other tables like address or other tables. Okay, you can add those tables as a child table and you can drill it down, but in subject area you can have only customer table itself. In subject area you cannot add the other tables. Yes, as a child you can add as a address, and as a grandchild you can add as a address type or communication type, whatever you have. Okay, and in subject area you can segregate the different customer category. Like we could have a kind of some customers which customer type is P, some of the customers which customer type could be Q or something else, right? So on the basis of this filter criteria, we can create a different set of customers, but the table will remain same. In both the case, the table will remain as a customer, base subject customer, right? So if you are creating a subject area group or subject area for a specific table, then in subject area that table will be there. No other table will be there. Yes, in subject area child and subject area grandchild we can add more tables. So we'll see how we can add this. So before defining any subject area child, subject area grandchild, so how, first of all, try to understand how MDM will understand this is like this address is a child and this communication type or address type is a grandchild. So for making MDM to understand these are the child and grandchild, we need to come here, we need to come to the schema and let's try to define the child and grandchild for customer. Come to match and merge path. So just remember that where we had defined a match and merge rule setup, so here we had defined some child records also, right? It's address and customer. So same like that, let's try to create a relationship between this base object customers and other base object. Now click on this plus. So see, so once you will define the what we say path, so if you want to come here, then you have to first define the relationship between these two table. Like you have to define a path from this table to this table, then you have to traverse with the means you have to traverse with a specific path. You cannot directly jump to this table. First of all, we have to define a path between these two table. Then we will come here. Then we will define a path between this table and this table. Then we will come here. Then we will define a path between this table and this table. Then we will come here. And then we will define a path between this table and this table. Then we will come here. Okay. We cannot directly come here. So we will come with this path. So we will create 1, 2, 3, 4. Four kind of path, then we will be able to come here. So once we'll click on add sign of this customer in the match merge setup, then we'll be able to see some relationship with this BDL type. Let's try to see it. If you're coming here, then here you can see it, there are some relationship with this BDL type. Here you can see, and this cross reference, as you know, the default, and this RBU class is because this is a hierarchy, but this is coming due to the we had defined relationship between this rel type. Let's give a relationship name as rel1 relationship 1. Let's press OK. So this two tables has been combined with this path. Now if you click on this path, plus sign, now you'll be able to see some relationship with the customers. Sorry, address, right? That relationship was associated with address, right? Now select this and let's take this as ATR. So now you'll be able to see, now we are able to reach to the address record with the help of this path. Now we want to reach to the communication type. How we can reach? So first of all, we have to reach to the relationship of communication type. Relationship of communication type. Let's keep the relationship to, and then we can reach to the communication type from here, right? So from here we can come to, let's give a communication type. Now you'll be able to see this communication type, right? So now you can see, if you want to come to communication type, then first of all you have to come to this table, then this table, then this table, then this table, right? In this way we can traverse. Let's try to save it. Okay, let's define some match merge logic. Let's take a fuzzy match. We have already defined the columns. Let's take some kind of person name. In person name, let's take a customer name here. Okay, and let's add one more column from the address. So here you can see all the all the tables available, right? Let's take address city. Let's give a name like that teacher. Field. That field is representing what we say city. Fine, let's try to define a match rules, a simple match rule set. Match rule set for employee. Let's create a simple match rules. So let's take this person name and city, and let's create this match rule here. Let's select fields, or you can select address. So these are the means person and field. These two are the mixed one. Let's try to select the fields. So one match rule we have defined, very match rule, a simple match rule. So it will do the searching on the basis of city and person name. So that is a fuzzy match rule, right? So if partial record will also match, then you will be able to find the match credited. Let's save it. So see why we are defining these match rules. So see, from the third party application or from the IDD, if you want to search some record, or if you want to find some duplicate some record, then that match rule will be fired in the backend. Because you have to instruct the MDM, right? How we want to find the match records. So this match rules will be fired in the backend, and it will tell MDM that this logic, on this logic we want to find the duplicate record, right? So now MDM can understand, right? You have given a, you have combined these two columns like a city and person name, and these are the fuzzy. So if the records will also not match exact, then also you can find the some duplicate records, right? So now on the basis of this logic, you can find some duplicate record from backend, and that logic we can apply from the front end of the IDD, right? So that's why we have defined it. And why we have defined the match path? Because we want to create a subject area, so customer is fine, we can create. But if you want to create a subject area child, unless and until you not define this, then we cannot create the subject area child for the customer, that is address. And also we cannot create the subject area grandchild. Okay. So if you want to combine more tables, or if you want to create a child and grandchild, then you have to define path here. So that's a very important question in interview. Like if you have a customer address and a third table, and you want to create a child and grandchild, then what you will do? So first of all, we will create the path of these all the tables in the match and merge setup. Okay, then we'll be able to see, on then we'll be able to create this child and grandchild subject area. Okay, unless and until not defined, we will not be able to create it. Okay, so here we have created a complete data model. Also, we have here we have created a kind of what we say. We have defined the path. Now let's come to address, and let's do the try to do the same thing. So for address, let's try to understand here. So for address, this is also child, and this is also child. So there is no grandchild of the address, right? Because we can come to this customer directly. So this will act as a child, and this will act also as a child. So there is no grandchild of address, right? So now let's try to define a path for address. Now come to match setup. Now here you can see the address table. Now let's click on plus. So address can be combined with the relationship type. Let's give a relationship name as A1. So name is already existing. Let's give a name as let's give array 3. So we have created this relationship. Now if you click on this, so now you'll be able to see customer, right? Now let's give a customer. So now we can reach to customer from address with the help of this relationship, right? Now if you want to define more relationship on customer, if you click plus, so here you cannot see any child. This is only cross reference, and this is a view class code. You cannot see any tables, because just try to remember the data model. In data model, what was there? In the middle we had address, and in the right hand side we had customer. So we have reached to the customer, so there is nothing after customer, right? So that's why we are not able to see any relationship with the third tables for this customer. So these are the means predefined what we say relationship, you know that, right? So now if you want to reach to communication type, then first of all you again have to come to address and try to define the relationship type for communication, relationship 4. And from this relationship 4 you can reach to the communication type here. Name is already existing. Let's take communication type one. Fine. So here you can see from this address you can reach to the customer, and from this address you can also reach to the communication type, right? So we have defined the appropriate path. Okay, let's select some fuzzy columns here. Let's select some person. Address part 1. In address part 1, let's take address line. Let's take a city one. For simplicity, let's add one more record from the customer. Let's take customer number, customer name. Let's take this column as your field for first name. Okay. Now let's define a simple match rule set for address also. Match rule set ATM. Now let's try to define a rule. So in rule, let's select both the columns, address and customer name. Okay. So here let's select the fields. So here you can see we are recapping the many previous things, right? So we will recap many previous things once we learn these advanced things. So finally we have defined the match rule set, so which will help us to search the record, or which will help us to find the duplicate records from the ITT. We can use it, and we have created a path so that we can create a child. So we don't have a grandchild of this address, right? We have only the child. So we have two child: communication type and custom. So now we can go to the IDD application. So before going to the IDD application, we have created the respective path and we created the some sample match row. Now how to access the IDD? So for that, go to browser and type the same URL like localhost/localhost8080 and /BDD. So there are two URL of the IDD application. So if you are hitting this URL, then you will be able to see the applications. Then you will be able to access the applications. But if you want to go to the admin console of the IDD, from where we can do the development, right? So for that, we need to add one more thing, that is config. Okay. So if you are entering this config, then you will be redirected to the admin console of the IDD. From there, you can do the development. Okay. So let's go to IDD admin console. So here you will get this console after hitting this. So here let's use the username as admin and password as admin. Now let's log in. Once you log in, then this screen you can see. So from here, you have to do all the development of the IDD. So this is a kind of client for the development of IDD. From here, we have to do all the development. Okay. So in IDD, we do develop the many applications. Okay. So let's try to create one application. So how to create? Just add on plus sign. Very easy. Now let's give the name of this application. So let's give the name as a customer. Let's give a simple name. Customer. So this application is written customer. So we are giving customer as a name. Now if you want to edit this, or if you want to do some more configuration, then here you can see that there is no edit signal is enabled, right? So what you can do, you can switch to other applications, then you can come back to customer, and then you will be able to see this edit symbol enabled, right? Or you can go to this edit part, you can go to this edit section from here also, or just go back, sorry, don't go back from there, sorry. So we had this one. So from here we switch to the edit, or if you want, you can also switch to the edit from here. So our customer, sorry, our application name is customer, right? So now click on this customer. Now you'll be able to see the edit application of the customer, right? So after creating the application, our first work is that we have to bind some ORS. Like in our environment, we have many ORS, right? So you want to bind your IDD with which ORS? So first is this is your first task. So let's try to bind this with some ORS. So here click on this add plus, and here let's select the ORS. So we are working on hierarchy one, right? Let's give the name of this ORS hierarchy one. Okay. And here you can see the logical ORS. This is showing hierarchy one, and this is telling us to select the different source systems. So let's select the admin source system, because admin source system will give us more control. So with the help of that, we can do more things. So let's take admin, and here hierarchy manager configurations. So once you have configured hierarchy manager in this ORS, then you will be able to see something. Otherwise you will see empty. So as we have developed one admin profile for this, we have developed admin profile for hierarchy manager. That's why we are able to see this admin. Otherwise, if you have not configured the hierarchy manager, then you will be able to see the empty. So you can select the empty one itself. Okay. So we have already configured this hierarchy. So let's select this profile and now click on bind. So now this ORS has been binded with this particular customer application. This customer application. Okay. So this customer application is pointing to this particular ORS. Now the second thing is that, as we know that we have a different subject area group, subject area child, and subject area grandchilds, right? So these are the main things which we have to configure inside this IDD. So here you can see subject area, and here you can see subject area group. Now just click on this. So see, So we cannot directly create a subject area child or subject area grandchild. If you want to create a subject area child, then first of all we have to create the subject area. And if you want to create a subject area grandchild, then first of all you have to create a subject area and subject area child. Then you can create a subject area grandchild. Okay. So here you cannot see any options for creating a subject area child, right? Because we have not created any subject area. So let's first create the subject area. And before subject area, let's create a subject area group, right? So for subject area group, we are following the naming convention as a subject area group, SAG. And we are creating it for suppose customer. Let's select logical values as a hierarchy one. And primary table, let's select, we are creating for customer, right? Now select OK. So now your subject area group has been created. Once you will click on the subject area group, now it will tell us and it will give us the flexibility to create the subject area. Okay. So before subject area group, you cannot directly create a subject area, right? So we have to create all the subject area, child, grandchild, one by one. We cannot directly jump to the others after skipping some middle step, right? So first of all, we have created a subject area group. Now we will try to create a subject area. Let's click on subject area. And here you can see this screen. So first of all, give the name of the subject area. Subject area, I'm giving the name of subject area as a customer. Display name as a customer. And hierarchy, here you can see if you have enabled hierarchy and configured hierarchy for this customer, then you'll be able to see here hierarchy. So for customer, like B customer, we had created an entity type as a customer, right? B customer was a one entity based object. So we had created a, remember it, you can see it from here also. Come to hierarchies. For customer, if we had created this customer entity type, remember it, okay? So that's why we are able to see this customer. In case of address, we will be able to see address. And in case of communication type, you will be able to see this communication type. Fine. So if you have configured hierarchy, then you can use it. Otherwise, you can use the empty default one. So just hold, guys, for a minute. Yeah. So here, what we have done, we have created a subject area group, and now we are in the process of creating the subject area child, right? Now let's create, we have created the subject area child. Now here we are able to see the hierarchy because we have created the entity type for this customer. So right, that's why we are able to see this customer. Once you select this, then you'll be able to see that all the things will be selected automatically, like base subject, class, code and customer. Now directly come to this layout. So here you can select all the columns, change your column selections, select all the columns, press OK. And these all the columns are coming from where? This is coming from the package, what the package you have created for this customer, display package, from there this column is coming. Okay. So here you can see this row ID object is yes, required. Okay, but if you want to add some record from IDD, so you don't know the row ID object of record, right? That will be created by MDM, right? So let's make this as not a required. Let's click on edit layout, then it will be changed to no. Now you can see this has been changed to no, right? And so this is a kind of, for these fields, you can make a kind of forum. You know, the there are some forums inside a web page, right? If you want to sign up there, some forum will come. It will tell us to put your first name, last name, email ID, right? So likewise, what the things, these four fields, we are creating a forum. Once we will click on plus signal, so it will give us a pop-up of this four field, okay? So what the restrictions we want to apply, like if you want to make some column as a required, so we can make it a required, like customer name, let's make it as a required. So click on customer name. Click on edit layout, and for customer name we want a big test area so that we can write a big names also. And here you can make this as a required, you can make it as a hidden, you can make it as editable. So let's make it as editable so that we can edit it also. Okay. Now here you can see the dependent lookups. So if you have dependent lookup, like if you have a country code and a state code, then if you select the country code, then a state code will come automatically. So if you have configured dependent lookup, then it will come. Or if you want to give default value, right? So suppose in some field you are not providing some value. So by default, which value you should take, you can define it. So for that, click on this add. And if you have some roles, so let's select that role, means for that role, the default value will be kind of, let's take this as a test. Okay, press OK. So for this field, customer name field, we will have a text area as a editor style. It will come as a big block, we know that, right? And then if we will not provide any value, then by default it will take a test. Okay. So required means, suppose you have make this customer name column as a not null column in the database. Not null means it will not take a null value. You have to supply some value, right? So of course, if you will supply null value, then it will throw some error. But suppose if you have met this customer name as a nullable from the database, okay, then you can pass the null value as well. But if you want to handle that nullability or null value from front end, you can handle it. You can make this field as required. So it will not allow you to enter any blank value. It will tell you to enter some value because we have made this field as required, right? So with the help of this only, we can only pass some not null data, right? So we can handle this not null or null value from the UI also. Same like we know the Facebook sign up forms and other sign up forms, right? So we can make some column as required and we can put some default values. Now press OK. Likewise, let's try to do OK and let's try to save it. What the thing is trying? OK. Here we have to select the display package, because through this display package only these all the columns will come. And after creating these applications, always try to save it. OK. If you not save it, and without saving, if you come here again, then you will see all the things lost. So always be very careful, and whatever things you are doing, always try to save it after some regular interval of time. Now if you come to your applications, now I am coming to application and now again I am going to edit mode. Then here I am able to see all the things, what the things I have created and what the things I have configured. I am able to see. So all the things are saved, okay. So after doing this all activity, always try to do the save. Fine. So let's try to create a child for this. So once you are clicking on this subject area, then it is giving us a flexibility to create a subject area child. Here you can see. Okay. So from here you can create a subject area child. And once you create a subject area child, you will be able to see this option of create a subject area grandchild. So these all the parts we will cover in tomorrow class, because we will give a 3 to 4 hours time. Likewise, we will give a 1 hour time each day, and the rest of the part we will tomorrow basically we will see this section. Like we have many things to understand here, like in subject area, these all the configurations we have to understand very carefully, like what are the mesh settings, search. Okay, so we have to give much and more time here. So tomorrow we are going to understand this subject area configurations. So that's all for today class. So thanks for your time.